Making a life worth living and a retirement worth having is really about how we help other people. It's really about what we do to help other people, and at this point in my life, I'm doing my best to help the people that I can. I openly am looking forward to sending something to someone who was really kind to me when I was in a difficult situation. But at this moment in time, I'm wondering, what do you do to help other people? Now, in life, we have moments of time to really reach out to those people, to really look at those people, and to really utilize the words and wisdom of many of the most famous people in the world, such as Warren Buffett, who talks openly about his number one rule, which is to help people. Now, in my life, I know that there are people trying to help me, but sometimes those people aren't trying to help me in a way in which I want to be helped. And that's a problem. In your life, have you ever had that experience? I don't really know whether or not you've had that experience or not, but it's sort of rough. We feel, and I feel, that in reality, that when someone needs help, it's not the question of let me know any way I can help you, because people sort of fail in that moment. It's literally being willing to sit down with them saying, what's your plan? And let's look at your plan, and let's prioritize your plan, and then let's look at what my skill sets are or my resources are that might be able to help you along your plan. And that's how you help someone. It's really important that when you give help to a person, that you actually help them on the path that they're trying to go to, on the projects they're trying to complete, and openly in the way and manner in which that they feel most comfortable. There's a lot of people in life who openly say they want to help someone or they think they're helping someone, but they literally might be interfering with the plans that a person has in place. And why does that happen? Because they're not with that individual 24/7. They're not with them in their planning moments and their private thoughts and when they're looking and thinking about how they're going to handle particular challenges that have come into their life. And sometimes challenges take a lot of time to repair. Other times they can be repaired in seconds with the right people in their life. But openly, that's what we talk about with those folks, is what can we do to help you? Now, I've been walking in the streets of Indianapolis during my lack of housing and openly met other men. They've been walking along through the wet and the trenches, and I literally say to them, would you like a plastic bag? And they say no. So if a person says no, you have to respect and regard that man or that woman who said no, I don't want any help. Sometimes it might just be a polite no, so you might have to ask again by saying, are you sure? Or something to that effect. The other way to handle things is literally to walk up to someone, tell them what's going on for you, and saying, I need a little bit of help in this. What can I do to make this work for both of us? And sometimes you might just find the generosity of spirit. I have found that literally all the time when I've been honest, sincere, and open to receiving some help in that little situation that I'm looking to accomplish, whether it be just getting food for the day, or whether it be getting a haircut, or whether it be doing something a lot more. I've spent a lot of time making phone calls to professional organizations, professional people, trying to get help on some little challenges that I'm facing right now that were put upon me by other people, not necessarily myself. Now, some people say, oh, you're trying to avoid responsibility. Not at all. They've avoided responsibility in what they've done and the impact that it's had on my ability to move forward in life in this time. But let's talk about your life. In your business, in your profession, in your career, what is it that you're trying to accomplish? What is it that you really need the most help with? How many new sales do you need in order to move your life forward? And what else do you need to accomplish in order to be who you are, all that you can be? And openly, that's what we're looking for when we're networking with people. Warren Buffett also talks about how it's important to find the right life partner. And sometimes we choose badly. We choose a partner who we get along with, who we have enjoyable times with, who makes us laugh, who makes us cry, who makes us do a lot of things. But in the end, are they really helping us to become everything that God has called us spiritually to be? And when I talk about life partners, I'm not only talking about those in our love group, in our love interests, in our love passions, but I'm also talking about the life strategic alliances that we make with people we can make profitable partnerships with in order to move life forward, in order to have that life worth living, and also to have that retirement worth having. You see, it's the life that we create right now that creates our retirement and our flexibilities that we're going to have when we're old, gray, and not functioning, maybe possibly quite as well as we once did. As I've aged, I've noticed things that I don't do quite as well, and I really work at that concept like that man in that wonderful story of A Beautiful Mind. I don't have his complexities, I certainly don't have his delusions, but openly what I learned from that film was that we have to sort of make ourselves shortcuts to help us when we struggle, to help us with note-taking, to help us with making sure we're on the path that we're trying to stay on for our own projects, our own pathways, our own abilities to gain lawful employment, and our own ways of making that retirement eventually happen for us when we're not as able to get that job as we many people find when they get to their kind of 50s and above. That it's hard to keep employment, it's harder to be taken seriously by a lot of young recruiters who don't have a lot of life experience and they've never had gone through a job loss or how long it can take to transition into a new position. But ultimately, that's what I'm always talking about. I'm always reminding people, whoever logs in, whoever listens in that moment of time, how important it is that relationships that we have in our lives are for us. When I lost the most important people of my life, three right in a row, including my father on top of that, it was really hard for me. It was really hard for me to perform as well as I once did because those people were essential to my soul group. They were essential to my soul soaring. They were essential to my life. They were essential to a lot of parts of who I was becoming as a man in this world and who I was becoming as a professional across the globe. And openly, that really hit me hard. I lost my spouse of many years. I lost a gal after that who merely made me shine and light up like a Christmas tree. And then I met and lost a very wonderful Catholic woman who taught me a lot about spirit. And we shared a lot of conversations about God that were really wonderful. And I really missed that conversation. I missed that opportunity. But she did something else in her mind with that creation of that relationship. And maybe God had a different plan for all of those relationships. But openly, when I lost my father, I lost someone I could talk to practically about what I could do in life and how I could do things in a way that made sense to men. And that's something I long for. Now, in your life, have you gone through loss? Have you lost friends? Have you lost colleagues? Have you lost people to a lot of different reasons? They've transitioned, they've moved away, they've lost their life, they've gone through illness. Sometimes we lose in life, and that's hard. But we always need those people around us to guide us, to help us move forward, and to literally give a helping hand. Sometimes they do so without a desire for anything in return. And those are the most godly people in the world. Other times they want some sort of payback, and that's okay too, because we have to earn our way in the place in the world, and that's lawful, isn't it? We all have the responsibility of producing and earning a living, a life worth living, and that's what I often talk about. And when we talk about these things, we're talking about what can we do to help other people? How can we serve them? How is what we do in our professions going to provide not only for our own families, but also for other families in which we're impacting by what we sell to them, what we provide to them? We certainly aren't with them 24 hours, and to make it sure that they implement exactly what we plan with them, but we can always try and do what we can do, which is to follow up with them, check in with them to see how they're really doing in life. And sometimes we just have to lend a simple helping hand. Other times we can make monumental shifts in an individual just by being a little bit more caring, a little bit more loving, and taking more time to pray to God about whether or not we're supposed to help them or whether or not we're supposed to do something else. Now, obviously, I'm sitting in a rather uncomfortable chair, and it's about time for me to time out on this audio cast for the day. And openly, I'm in a public place, which is why I'm using my headphones. But I really hope you're listening. I really hope you're thinking about how do you impact other people in your life, in your world, and in everything that you do today, tomorrow, and the next day until it's time for you to retire. And that's my hope for you. I'm wishing you the best holiday season for you, your family, your loved ones, and anyone who's in your social network that really means something to your soul. This has been Blake Ensign of Blaze Communications, LLC, looking for opportunities to help you shine, help me shine, and to really make the world a brighter place.